Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create slash commands for your Discord bot and Discord PY. If there's a more recent video about this, it'll be linked up here. Okay, so I'm going to demonstrate the basic command we'll be working on. So I can use test, and we can impute a name. So we'll just say win, and it says, hello win, I was made with Discord PY. Okay, before we start coding, we need to make sure we have the developmental version of Discord PY. To install a developmental version of Discord PY, we can clone the GitHub. This is the GitHub, so you just copy this link, and we can use git clone with the link. I'll have this in the description, and it'll create a new file, or not a new file, a new folder. And I already cloned it here, so we'll be using it. So I'm going to create a file called /commands.py, and let's begin coding. So first, we need to import a couple things. We need to import Discord and app commands from Discord. Okay, now we're done with our imports. We need to subclass our client now. Okay, so we have subclassed our client. So we define our intents in here. Intents equals discord.intents.default. This will enable all our intents, but our privileged intents. And you can put like your other options in here, like your status and such. So let's create a variable, synced. We have this variable to make sure that we don't sync our commands more than once. Now let's work on our onReady. So this event is triggered whenever our bot logs in, and we're going to need to create our command tree. Okay, so we have created our command tree. So our client will be this. This is our subclass of our client. So we'll call it client, and then our tree will be our app commands.command tree. So this is basically like a container for all our slash commands. And on our onReady, we're going to sync our commands with that. So first, we need to wait until we're ready, and then we're going to check if the sync variable is false. If it is, we're going to sync. Otherwise, we'll just say we've logged in. Okay, so basically what this does is that we first wait until the bot is ready, and then we check if synced is false. If it's false, we're going to sync our commands to a specific guild. We do this because guild-specific syncing occurs nearly instantaneously, while global syncing means across all your servers can take up to 24 hours. If you want to do a global sync, you just cut out this guild specification, and you're good to go. And then once we sync, we're going to set sync to true, so this is called only once, since onReady can be called multiple times, so we need to be careful of that, and then we print that we've logged in. Also, make sure you don't restart your bot more than twice a minute, and make sure that you have this variable here. Otherwise, your commands might be synced multiple times, which can cause your bot to be rate limited. So we're almost done. Let's work on our slash command. We'll call it test. Okay, so this is the general gist of our slash command. Its name is going to be test. Description is going to be testing. Its guild is going to be our testing server. So this will only sync to a specific server. If you want to sync it to all your servers, you just cut out the guild argument. If you want to sync to multiple servers, you can use the guilds argument. And then you can have a list of IDs. And then on our callbacks, so we can have our interaction as a Discord interaction. And let's also have an input. Let's call it name. And it's going to be a string. And now let's work on our callback. So we're going to have await interaction.response.send message. This will send a message. If your processing or your response takes more than 3 seconds, you're going to want to defer. And I'll leave that information in the description. So, but since our response will be very short, we don't do any processing, we can just respond. So we can use await interaction.response.send message. Okay, so this is basically it. We respond saying hello with the name they imputed in and said, I was made with this PY. Now we're ready to run our bot. So we can just use client.run and let's impute our token. Let's paste that there and let's run our code. And let's wait until it says that we have logged in. We have logged in. Now let's test our command. Let's run test. And our name, we can just say wind again. Oh yeah, we forgot one part. So if you want an ephemeral message like this, where only the user can see the message, you can add ephemeral equals true. So basically what you do is you add ephemeral equals true. Let's rerun the bot. And let's run test again. Let me run. Says, hello test, I was made with Discord UI. So if you found this video helpful, please consider liking and subscribing. I know everyone says this, but it really helps out the channel if you do. And if you have any questions, feel free to comment down below in the comment section or join our Discord, which the link is on screen, and I'll do my best to help you out. Thank you for watching.